It's official. The AI wars between Microsoft and Google just got more intense, with the product announcement at this year's Build being pretty similar to those announced at I/O. Here's a summary of all AI announcements made during the keynote. First and most exciting, ChatGPT now has internet access with Bing Search. Responses by ChatGPT now include citations and up-to-date information pulled from real-time search results on Bing. This setting is default on ChatGPT Plus, immediately available, and it is teased to be available on the free version sometime soon. Starting heavy on ChatGPT integrations, GPT-4 plugins are now available across all web pages when using the Edge browser. Here is an example of that in action.
Let's take a look. Here I am in ChatGPT, and as you can see now, Bing is the default, and when I come in and select it, I can now ask sort of real-time queries. For example, let's ask what I should expect to hear about Build and .NET. And what you can see is the results now are more up-to-date, they include fresh content, and they include citations. In fact, if you can see the links on that page there, you can click those and those will take you straight to a web page that's sourced by Bing.
Microsoft 365 AI Copilot, which is quite similar to Duet AI for Google Workspace, is coming to all Microsoft 365 clients, with a number of assistive features like editing documents in Word. The team says it best with these examples.
Here, I'm going to use Microsoft 365 Copilot. Now I'm in Microsoft Word, and I'm going to need some help for drafting a legal contract. I got a legal contract here, and I need some help with California law. So I'm going to call three plugins from Thomson Reuters to edit this document. First thing is I'll go into Copilot, and I'll pull it up, and I'll say, hey, help me understand how to edit the limitation of liability using the Practical Law plugin. It'll read the document, find the paragraph, and make that change. Next, I want to know if this is enforceable under California law. So I'll call the Westlaw plugin that will do that analysis, and it'll come back and give me an analysis about it from a legal perspective. And finally, since we're making lots of changes, I'd like to know the summary of all of these changes. And with Document Intelligence, I get a simple table that shows you all of those changes in an easy-to-read format. By joining the power of Microsoft 365 Copilot in Word with the support of these real powerful plugins like Thomson Reuters, now you can draft a legal contract in so much more powerful way.
Windows Copilot was also announced. Using a similar side pane to Bing Chat, the app is integrated into all parts of Windows. It's honestly what Cortana could have been if it had the power of an LLM like GPT-4. To use Windows Copilot, you can simply open the app on the taskbar and ask it to assist you with a number of things in natural language, including suggestions on how to make your PC function faster. And I think this is going to save a lot of customer service reps a lot of stress, so people don't have to call them for every simple issue anymore. Summarized by Satya, saying he thinks this is going to make every user of Windows a power user of Windows. Here is an example of Windows Copilot in action.
Here I am in a coding project on my PC, but I want to configure my PC to help me be more creative and more productive. All I have to do now is invoke the Windows Copilot. I now just come down here to the taskbar, I click on that, and now we'll pop up the Windows Copilot on the right. This side pane here will be consistent across every app that you use on your PC. And just like with Bing Chat, I can now ask it questions like, how can I adjust my system to get work done? And not only will I get a bunch of great suggestions, but watch this. I can now, with one click, take action on those suggestions. For example, I can put it into focus mode. I also know that as developers, we like dark mode. There's a suggestion here for dark mode. So with one click, I'm now here on the dark side. And to really get going, I want to get that coding playlist going. So I'll pull the plugin from Spotify and say, give me a great coding playlist. In this case, Chill Vibes will come up. And now I'll have it ready to go. And finally, there's a suggestion here that says, hey, to organize your PC, let's take advantage of Snap. So with one click, it snaps all the windows right in the place I need them so I can be super productive. What do you think?
Azure AI Studio was announced next, which is basically Microsoft's version of Google's Vertex AI platform, allowing enterprises to build AI tools in Azure whilst prioritizing AI safety. It basically combines Azure, GitHub, and Visual Studio into one place as part of a Copilot stack feature called AI Orchestration, which also allows for prompt and response filtering, data grounding, and plugin execution. Microsoft's entire suite of AI products now runs on Azure AI. This is Azure.
Introducing Azure AI Studio, a full lifecycle tool to build, customize, train, evaluate, and deploy the latest next generation models responsibly. With just a few clicks, developers can ground AI models with their structured and unstructured data to quickly and easily build customized, cutting-edge conversational experiences for their customers. Developers can take advantage of a new model catalog that works with the popular models organizations use, including those from Azure OpenAI Service, Hugging Face, and many other open source models. With Prompt Flow, developers can combine relevant data from your organization and create a detailed prompt to get better results. Prompt Flow works with foundation, internally developed or open source models, and uses popular open source tools, LangChain, and Semantic Kernel. And because the AI systems we build are designed to support our AI principles, with Azure AI Content Safety, we are making it easier for you to test and evaluate your AI deployments for safety.
AI safety is heavily emphasized as built into the toolchain, with Microsoft's half-decade-long principles translated into the engineering processes at the core of each AI product, whilst following compliance and agreeing to oversight. This process starts with testing. Microsoft has built an entire responsible AI dashboard that helps developers during the product testing phases to ensure that the product in development is safe according to their compliance guidelines and principles grounded in a safety-first prompt flow. The next step in the process is provenance, which essentially helps to automatically watermark Azure AI-created images, audio, and video, similar to Google AI's watermark tools for its Universal Translator, and lastly, deployment. Azure AI Safety takes all previous safety parameters used for the deployment of Bing Chat as a default available set of features for developers to use, allowing developers to take open source models and use the AI safety features of Azure AI Studio to make the product safe at the point of deployment. Microsoft Fabric brings AI to data analytics by unifying all Microsoft Analytics software like Microsoft Power BI, Azure Data Factory, and Azure Synapses. Fabric unifies all data, computing storage, and brings together governance and security with the business model across different types of analytics workload to fuel the next generation of AI applications. The keynote ends with a note on why we build, talking about the advancements humanity has made with technology and how the age of AI can define what economic growth can look like and why this economic growth is necessary for human development. Let me know what you think about Microsoft Build 2023, and did you prefer this to Google I/O? I feel like Satya is perhaps a better storyteller than Sundar, and this feels like a much more personal journey that I would want to be a part of. For contrast and comparisons, check out this video on all AI announcements made at the 2023 Google I/O keynote. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day.